Hi, everyone. That's enough procrastinating. It's time to get back to spirit science. Okay, episode 22 comes in 5 parts, and I'm not going to go over all of it. I'm just going to focus on the really stupid stuff, like when Jordan tries. Just watch.
Let's put on our science hats and see what we can find out.
I trust you can all see where this is going.
While doing research on Wikipedia, you find pages upon pages with bajillions of words describing these crazy formulas revealing the secrets of the universe, everything we know in modern science.
Wikipedia articles are sometimes written by experts who are basically just trying to show off how much they know about a subject. And that's great if you're looking for a technical summary of a very advanced topic, but it's also something that makes it difficult to understand as a layman.
It's theorized across the board, from creation myths, the basic geometry of the flower of life, and even in the Big Bang Theory, that light is among the first things created at the beginning of everything.
No, creation myths and sacred geometry don't theorize, they assert.
Let's take a look at particle physics and quantum physics. They may help us crack this code.
Yes, I will now subject myself to a lesson in particle physics from someone who doesn't understand the difference between a Hamiltonian operator and a Ricci tensor. Or an integral and a derivative. Or a Jew and an alien.
As our sciences have looked smaller and smaller to find the smallest particle, we have reached a point where things get so small that we can no longer define what they look like. We try and define what particles are through abstract concepts and mathematics, because we say that particles are unseeable.
You realize that those abstract concepts mean something, right?
And unknowable.
No, how can you say they're unknowable when we have equations that describe how they behave, how they interact? Equations that make testable predictions that have been confirmed on countless occasions. Quantum mechanics is the single most successful theory in all of science.
Some scientists have actually been known to cut infinite numbers when they find them, because they're deliberately looking for finiteness, instead of embracing the infinite nature of reality.
No, numbers are rounded so that you don't have to write out an infinite number of decimals, because that would take a while.
Check out the movie Black Hole to see this happening in action.
Made by Nassim Haramein. Yep. The protons are black holes, guy. No thanks, Jordan. I don't get my scientific understanding from comedies.
Particles are called particles because they're too small to be seen by instruments we have in science at this time.
No, particle is a generic term for something that's so small that its radius is insignificant.
What that means is that we don't really know what particles even are. If we knew what they were, they would not be particles anymore. They would be described.
No, there's nothing about the definition of particle that says it has to be something we don't know anything about. Jordan, now you're just making shit up.
Light and other particles that move at the speed of light are assumed to have no mass. The speed of light, also known as the speed of massless particles, is about 299,792,458 meters per second.
No, exactly. That's actually how the meter is defined.
What we know in the field of science is that there's something that translates these particles from one side of the equation to the other.
What equation? That doesn't mean anything.
If you ask the scientists this question, they would tell you that it's the Higgs field, the ever-permeating field that gives things mass. In essence, light-speed particles pass through the Higgs field and slow down, and gain a property of mass.
No, they have no mass, unless you're talking about relativistic mass, but that has nothing to do with the Higgs field.
The popular Higgs boson is the particle that is created upon the light-speed particle merging with the Higgs field.
No, a Higgs boson is an excitation of the Higgs field that can be detected at very high energies, like in particle accelerators. Let me try an analogy. Jordan, don't take this literally. Consider the Higgs field a pond. Now, you drop a rock into the pond, you get ripples on the pond. That's like the Higgs field reacting to the presence of a particle. Now, what if you drop a rock with sufficient energy? You drop it from high enough. Well, then it might not just form ripples, you might get a splash. Now, that splash might cause drops to leave the surface of the water. Those drops would be analogous to the Higgs boson. And I repeat myself, this is an analogy! Don't take it literally!
I think there's an important piece of information that we're missing here, and it starts with asking some questions. First of all, what even is mass?
It's the property of a physical system that creates resistance to acceleration. It's a measurement of inertia.
And second, why do we believe that light has no mass?
Well, simply put, because if it had mass, it wouldn't be able to travel at c, which we also know as the speed of light. Because it happens to be the speed at which light travels.
On Wikipedia, mass is said to represent an amount of matter, but then it goes on to say that the term matter has no universally agreed upon definition.
Right, which is why, as the article said, defining mass as an amount of matter isn't gonna work.
Because of all of our fancy equations as described earlier, we have kind of thrown all ideas about what light could actually look like out the window.
No, it's not because of the equations, it's because it's a nonsensical question. Jordan, what does E minor smell like?
In favor of a complex equation that looks like this.
No, that equation makes absolutely no sense. There's even a bracket missing. This wouldn't be some gibberish you just made up, would it? And that's not what a hydrogen atom looks like.
I want to take it back to simple. What if we could know the shape of light? What if we could actually define what the structure of light, as well as every particle and thing in existence, were?
Then Atlantis would be real, thoughts would magically alter reality, Egyptians would procreate telepathically, water would be an element, Drunvalo Melchizedek, Nassim Haramein, and Greg Braden would have Nobel Prizes, Indiana Jones 4 would be a documentary, and Jews would be from space!
Let's think about photosynthesis. A burst of energy from the sun travels towards the Earth as both a wave and a particle. It has properties of both, and it's moving at the speed of light, and passes through a plant. That plant then absorbs the information and energy that it needed from the wave particle that passed through it. The plant then uses that information to create something with mass.
No, it uses the energy to process materials, primarily carbon, that the plant gets from carbon dioxide in the air. The mass comes from those materials, not from the sunlight. Jordan, this is elementary school science!
In addition to supporting the theory of light being solid...
That's not a theory. That's not even coherent. A solid is matter made up of particles that are bound together by forces that prevent them from moving a significant amount relative to each other. To say that light is a solid is simply nonsensical.
Doesn't that also seem to fit the model of the Higgs boson too?
No.
I could be wrong. It's just an idea.
Well, credit where credit's due, Jordan, at least you admit it. But if you know so little, maybe you should learn more before you make a presentation like this. Here's how this video should have gone.
What is light? What does science have to say about it? Well, let's see. I don't understand the Wikipedia article, and I don't want to spend years studying this just to make a video about it, so I have to say, I really don't know. I mean, it's what comes out of the sun, or a light bulb, it's what allows us to see. It's some kind of wave in something. It's weird, because it's not some material that's waving. It's got something to do with probabilities of, well, something. I don't get it, but it's a wave anyway. And it's also a bunch of particles, and that's weird, too. It just doesn't seem to make any sense. I mean, it... Oh, wait, if light is a particle, maybe it has mass. But, yeah, I read somewhere that it doesn't. Could this have something to do with that Higgs field thing I keep hearing about? I checked the Wikipedia page for that, too, but it was even more complicated. You know, I'm just gonna say that this subject seems a lot more complicated than I thought it would be, and... Look, I'm just gonna have to admit that I'm in over my head. I really have a lot to learn before I talk about a subject like this. But, you know, you should learn from this. It's a valuable experience to see just how little you know sometimes. And while it may be fun to speculate, I'm glad I didn't because, well, considering how little I know, that would just be pulling stuff out of my ass. Speculation needs to be based on something. Oh well, this was a really short video, but that's it. See you next time.
And you know what? While your idiot fanboys, who, by the way, keep sending me hateful messages in the name of peace and love, would certainly think less of you if you did that. Every scientifically literate person around would do a double take and go, What? Jordan said something that wasn't retarded? But no. Instead, we get this.
And if light is a solid, well, what could it look like? What my friends and I have come up with is a combination of three forms.
Yep, sacred geometry, which leads to more of this.
Over the past year, I've been learning that the Vesca Pisces is one of the most important keys for waking up and transformation on this planet. It is a model for bringing people together to create powerful change on this planet.
Which has absolutely nothing to do with light, but hey, on the bright side, pun, at least he's not butchering physics anymore.
The best way I can describe this is by examining the fundamental behavior of a single-celled human. This single cell at that point is a single organ. Can you guess which organ it is?
It's not an organ, it's a single cell, a stem cell to be precise.
Skin.
Please go back to butchering physics.
It's something new entirely. The singularity.
An embryo is a singularity?
Singularities are consciousness.
Okay, Jordan, you really don't know what a singularity is.
The singularity is like the equal sign in E equals MC squared.
For the record, in mathematics, a singularity is a point at which a mathematical object is ill-defined. A very good example is the function f of x equals 1 over x, which has a singularity at x equals 0, as 1 over 0 is undefined. In physics, a singularity is a point in spacetime with non-zero energy and yet zero volume, resulting in infinite density. In either case, it has absolutely nothing to do with consciousness or equality.
These planes are intimately connected with each other.
What planes? You mean energy and the physical? Because energy is physical.
So if singularities are in the middle of both of these places, how exactly do they work?
In the middle of what places? What are you talking about? Wait, never mind. Yes, Jordan, please tell us how singularities work.
Singularities are everywhere. Every atom has a singularity, regardless of if the atom is acting as a part of a person or that couch that we talked about previously. Perhaps there are different forms and functions that singularities have.
Wait, hang on.
Every atom has a singularity.
Could you repeat that?
Every atom has a singularity.
Excuse me. Why no, Jordan? Atoms do not have singularities in them.
Thrive recently did a video about this, which puts it all into perspective. They described the toroidal field and the way that they couple together with each other. When the field spins one way, it has a different effect than when it spins in the opposite direction.
Yeah, I really don't care what other pseudoscience peddlers have to say about it.
Toroidal fields must be able to come together at any angle, which you can see by just looking at the flower of life. For example, in coming together side by side to create the Vesca Pisces, they create a new singularity in the middle.
No, there's no point of infinite density that... Wait, are you talking about mathematical singularities now all of a sudden?
A blending of matter and energy between the two.
What? That's got nothing to do with either physical or mathematical singularities. What the hell are you talking about?
If this is the creation of a new singularity, what that would mean is a new wormhole, so to speak, for matter to translate into energy.
Wormhole. A non-physical, non-mathematical singularity is a wormhole that translates matter into energy. Okay, for the record, a wormhole is a tunnel between two points in space-time. Yes, like in Star Trek. Yes. Yes, it's a real phenomenon. At least, it's allowed by the laws of physics as we currently understand them. I mean, it's never been observed, but it's theoretically possible.
If matter cannot be created nor destroyed...
It can. Matter can be created through pair production, and it can be destroyed by interacting with antimatter.
Light appears to be something fundamental to reality. There are things with singularities that create and give light as its primary function, such as a star.
Stars don't have singularities. Well, I guess you could say that some stars do, but we don't call them stars. They are dead stars who have undergone gravitational collapse. We call those black holes.
So at that moment of conception, the tiny singularities of each the seed and the egg together create a new singularity completely.
Oh, for crying out loud.
People often ask me, when does the soul come into the body?
Let me guess. When a space Jew's thought realm frequency onks the female energy through the singularity of a toroidal field into the mass consciousness of the fourth dimension?
I believe that the soul is there from the original point of union, just as the singularity is.
Close enough. At least it was stupid.
And let's always be open to exploring new ideas and possibilities, and really testing them to see if they're true.
Agreed. And Jordan, you should follow that advice. See ya. Then Atlantis would be real, thoughts would magically alter reality. Then Atlantis would be real, thoughts would magically alter reality, Egyptians would procreate telepathically. Then Atlantis would be real, thoughts would magically alter reality. Damn it! Let me guess. When a space Jew onks the female energy through the singularity of... When a space Jew's thought realm frequency onks the female energy through the singularity to the fourth dimension of some... Damn it. Alright, toroidal field and mass consciousness. Let me guess. When a space Jew... Space Jew's thought realm frequency onks the female energy... Let me guess. When a space Jew onks his